Okay, so this video basically involves the understanding of the different isomers in organic chemistry. We have to deal with different types of isomers like homo isomers, enantiomers, diastereoisomers, constitutional isomers, stereoisomers. So what are these? So today we will discuss about the different types of isomers, their origin, their nomenclature. So obviously the concept of isomerism comes when two molecules have same molecular formula. So if two molecules with the same molecular formula are superposable, then they are called homomers. If they are not superposable, then they are basically isomers. So what is the superposability or superposable term means? So it is basically the same molecule. If, let's say for example, this molecule, then this molecule, these two molecules are same, so they are superposable. In other words, this molecule and this molecule, these two molecules are same, they are superposable. If the CH3 group is down or in equatorial position, then they will be not superposable. In that scenario, they will be isomers. So isomers are basically two molecules which has either different atom connectivity or same atom connectivity with different orientation of the atoms. So for example, so when the atom connectivity is different, the isomers are called constitutional isomers. For example, this molecule and this molecule. These two molecules are isomers because they contain same number of hydrogen, carbon and chlorine atoms, but their connectivity is different. Here the chlorine is attached with the 4 position, where in this case it is attached with the number 2 carbon atom. So in this scenario, these two molecules are called constitutional isomers. But when the connectivity is same, let's say this chlorine atoms is now here, so we can clearly see that this chlorine atom is also in the 4 position of the cyclohexane ring, and in this molecule also it is in the 4 position. But what is the difference? The difference is basically the orientation of this chlorine atom. Here it is in the axial position, but here it is in the equatorial position. So these type of isomers are called stereoisomers, where the atom connectivity is same, but the orientation is different. Okay, so stereoisomers also has two categories: diastereoisomer and enantiomer. So what is the criteria for these two isomers? So suppose we have two molecules, two isomers, or two stereoisomers. Let's be specific. So when we have two stereoisomers, but one pair of stereoisomers possesses a non-superimposable mirror image relationship, then it is called enantiomer. So what is that non-superimposable mirror image relationship? Suppose we have this molecule, this molecule. In this molecule, the atom orientation is like this, and we have this molecule also. Okay, so these two molecules, we can see that they are clearly mirror images of one another, but we have to check whether they are superimposable or not. To check it, we have to first align the CH3 carbon and hydrogen with respect to this CH3 hydrogen and carbon, CH3 carbon and hydrogen. So for that we have to rotate via this axis, this carbon-carbon axis, 180 degree. So after 180 degree rotation, the molecule will be like this. The bromine will be in the above the plane and the chlorine will go in the below the plane. So now you can see that this CH3 merges upon this CH3, this carbon merges upon this carbon, this hydrogen merges upon this hydrogen, but this bromine is going in the chlorine's place and this chlorine is going into the bromine's place. So we can clearly see that they are non superimposable mirror images. Mirror image. So this is this kind of relationship. If two isomers possess, then they are called enantiomers of one another. So what is the criteria for diastereomer? It is very simple. When there is no superimposable mirror image relationship, then between two isomers, then those isomers are called diastereomers. For example, okay, let us draw in this fashion. This molecule and this molecule, sorry, this this is a particular molecule and this one. So this is a chiral center, this is also a chiral center, this one a chiral center, this one also is a chiral center. So these two molecules are not possess the mirror image relationship. Forget about the superimposable criteria, they are not mirror images with each other. So this pair of isomers are called diastereomers. So this is a tabular form of the different type of isomers you will interact or you will encounter during the course of organic chemistry. Okay, that's it. I hope you have learned something from this video. Thank you for watching.